All scripture is inspired by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, for training in righteousness, so that the man of God may be adequate, equipped for every good work. Our beginning be in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. As we join in worshiping this morning, let us join in singing from English hymn number 9. English hymn number 9. We shall sing the first and the second verses. Sanctified in Christ Jesus and called to be saints, Lift up your hearts and make your prayers and supplications known unto God with reverence and holy fear. Surely this is none other than the Son of God. This is the great gate of heaven, the house of God. Here he is pleased to grant us comfort and joy and the peace that passeth all understanding. Here we hear him speak to us in his word and sacraments. It is meet and right, therefore, that we should come near to him who has drawn unto us and offered him the sacrifice of our praise and thanksgiving. Remember, however, that we have sinned and are unworthy to stand in God's holy presence. Let us with true penitence confess our sins, saying, Our Heavenly Father, we, miserable sinners, confess before thee that we have trespassed against thy holy laws, often and in many ways, by evil thoughts, words and deeds, by unbelief, ingratitude and deceit, and by not loving the brethren as we ought to have done. We have become unworthy of thy judgments and even of eternal death. We do earnestly repent and are sorry for these our sins. We see no other way of redemption and consolation than that which comes through thy grace, which exceeds our guilt, even the precious redemption wrought by our Lord Jesus Christ. We therefore beseech that thou wilt freely give us our Son. Forgive us our sins, restore us to thy fellowship, and sanctify us by thy Holy Spirit, to serve thee in newness of life and in gratitude. Amen. Come to me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, and I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. But all you that forget the Lord and still love to live in unrighteousness and sin, hear the word of God. Today you will hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as in the provocation. Let the wicked forsake his way and unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, for he will abundantly pardon. Amen. Let us offer thanks to God. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we thy unworthy servants do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We beseech thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of his life, but above all for thy immeasurable love in the redemption of our world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for thy holy word and sacrament, and for the hope of glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, our Heavenly Father, let thy grace preserve and presence be with us and grant us peace, trustfulness and courage on our pilgrimage. Give us grace that we hold thee fast with a loving and adorable heart, and grant that our affection be fixed only unto thee. Teach us to listen to your voice, that we may never stifle in its warning. Lead us in the right way till we pass on to the road and the land of promise. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now we shall have the responsive reading of Psalms.
Psalms 111. Praise the Lord. I will exalt the Lord with all my heart in the council of the upright and in the assembly.
Great are the works of the Lord. They are pondered by all who delight in them.
Glorious and majestic are his deeds, and his righteousness endures forever.
He has caused his wonders to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and compassionate.
He provides food for those who fear him. He remembers his covenant forever.
He has shown his people the power of his works, giving them the lands of other nations.
The works of his hands are faithful and just. All his precepts are trustworthy.
They are steadfast forever and ever, done in faithfulness and uprightness.
He provides redemption for his people. He ordained his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All who follow his precepts have good understanding. To him belong eternal praise.
Praise the Lord. The appointed text for today's Theological Sunday worship service is taken from the Old Testament, Book of Exodus, chapter 3, verses 1 to 12. Book of Exodus, chapter 3, verses 1 to 12. Let us read and hear the word of God. Now Moses was tending the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian. And he led the flock to the far side of the desert and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There the angel of God appeared to him in flames of fire from within a bush. Moses saw that though the bush was on fire, it did not burn up. So Moses thought, I will go over and see this strange sight, why the bush does not burn up. When the Lord saw that he had gone over to look, God called to him from within the bush, Moses, Moses. And Moses said, Here I am. Do not come any closer, God said. Take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. Then he said, I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. At this, Moses hid his face because he was afraid to look at God. The Lord said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I have heard them crying out because of their slave drivers, and I am concerned about their suffering. So I have come down to rescue them from the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them up out of that land into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey, the home of the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. And now the cry of the Israelites has reached me, and I have seen the way the Egyptians are oppressing them. So now, go, I am sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt. But Moses said to God, Who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt? And God said, I will be with you, and this will be the sign to you that it is I who have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you will worship God on this mountain. Here ends today's Old Testament scripture reading. The New Testament scripture reading is taken from Paul's second letter to Timothy, chapter 2, verses 1 to 13. Paul's second letter to Timothy, chapter 2, verses 1 to 13. You then, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And the things you have heard me say in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to reliable men who will also be qualified to teach others. Endure hardship with us like a good soldier of Christ Jesus. No one serving as a soldier gets involved in civilian affairs. He wants to please his commanding officer. Similarly, if anyone competes as an athlete, he does not receive the victor's crown unless he competes according to the rules. The hard-working farmer should be the first to receive a share of the crops. Reflect on what I am saying, for the Lord will give you insight into all this. Remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, descended from David. This is my gospel, for which I am suffering, even to the point of being chained like a criminal. But God's word is not chained. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they too may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. Here is a trustworthy saying, if we died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we disown him, he will also disown us. If we are faithless, he will remain faithful, for he cannot disown himself. Here ends today's scripture reading. May the Lord add his blessings to these words. Amen.
I exhort you all to confess your sins in God and in Jesus Christ by saying with me the Apostles' Creed. Let us say the Apostles' Creed in unison. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Here are the announcements for the week. The UBM Church Council is thrilled to bring before you the UBMC Fest 2021. An array of exciting events such as Bible quiz, pictorial puzzles, identifying gospel songs, crossword, virtual tele games, general knowledge quiz, and many more fun-filled levels of competition that will provide you with a platform to exhibit your talents, hone your skills, and unravel your hidden gifts and abilities. The event will be held both at the local level. For those who progress, will further compete at the central level. We look forward to your enthusiastic participation, wholehearted support and prayer to make this event a grand success. The last date of Google registration for this event is tomorrow, that is 12th July 2021. Tomorrow, that is 12th July 2021. The Silver Jubilee Education Scholarship forms are available for all school-going children, requesting all eligible candidates to kindly contact your local pastor or local elder. Forms to be collected, duly filled and submitted latest by 18th July 2021. Similarly, the KPCA Education Scholarship forms are also available for all school-going children, requesting all eligible candidates to kindly contact your local pastor or local elder. Forms to be collected for the KPCA Education Scholarship duly filled and submitted by 25th July 2021 latest. Confirmation classes shall commence for this year at the earliest. However, based on the guidelines issued by the government as well as on the situation during this period, the confirmation will be conducted thereafter. Those students who desire to be confirmed this year, kindly contact your local pastor at the earliest. This morning we have in our midst Reverend Dr. Hubert Watson, Principal of Karnataka Theological College, Mangalore, who will be sharing the Word of God on this occasion of Theological Sunday. On behalf of the UBM Church Council and UBM Church family, we welcome him and we thank him for accepting our humble invitation. Death announcement. We regret to announce the sad demise of Mr. Wilson Sananda Bangera, aged 80 years, who went to be with the Lord on Sunday, 4th July 2021, who was earlier a member of UBM Vishranti Church, Malad. We request you all to pray for the bereaving family and may God grant them his peace and comfort that passeth all human understanding. During the closing hymn, we shall be gathering the offering. You can set aside your offerings and transfer the same via web transfer or online transfer. We thank you all for your generous contribution and support thus far. This has greatly supported the ministry of our church. May God bless you all.
As announced, the UBM Fest is fast approaching, and we are happy to note that over 240 registrations are received. We hereby urge and beckon all parents to enroll your little ones, and also the children, the youth, and all the members of all age groups to exhibit your gifts and talents and glorify our Lord. This is the best platform to unravel your skills, and by doing so, promote your respective church to lift up the trophy for your respective churches. This is a God-sent opportunity to light up your lives during this pandemic and get involved enthusiastically in the UBMC Fest. The last date has been extended to 12th July 2021. Come on, be a sport and make this event a great success.
Before we hear the word of God, we shall spend time in worshipping and singing songs of praise.
Psalms 104 verse 1 says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, O Lord my God. Thou art very great, thou art clothed with honor and majesty. Our God is great and mighty, most worthy of our praise. This morning, let's worship Him in the splendor of His holiness."
Power, our God, our God.
book of James, chapter 4, verse 8 says, "Draw near to God, and He will draw near to you." As we continue in our worship, let us with sincere heart come close to our God and surrender our lives to Him.
I surrender. Let us pray. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you for this time of worship. We give thanks and praises for the privilege of meditating upon your word. Today, as we observe this Sunday as the Theological Sunday, we give thanks and praises for the theological mission of the Church. Through your Holy Spirit, you guide us to know you and to understand your mission in this world. Lord, as we meditate now, your word, guide us through your Holy Spirit. Help us to understand the mystery of your mission through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This Sunday is being observed as the Theological Sunday. This Sunday is set apart as Theological Sunday to remind ourselves, the Church, the theological task and the theological mission of the Church. On behalf of Karnataka Theological College, Mangalore, I bring greetings to you all on behalf of the faculty and the students. Karnataka Theological College is one of the oldest seminaries or theological colleges in India. Karnataka Theological College, known as KTC, was established in 1847 by the Basel missionaries. In the early 19th century, one of the kings in Germany gave a donation of 10,000 ducats and asked the Basel mission to establish a theological college in India. With the intention of doing mission in India and also to start a theological college, the Basel missionaries arrived in India in the year 1834. It was when Hermann Mögling, a German missionary, came to Mangalore, the importance to start a theological college took its prime place. But they were not able to straight away start a theological college because there were no Christians, there were no educated people. Hence, they had to start the mission work, preaching the gospel, and also to establish the schools. In the year 1847, they were able to start a catechist school. In the year 1863, a seminary was started. The catechist school was upgraded to a seminary and it was called BEM Theological Seminary. In 1947, the seminary was affiliated to the Serampore University. In the year 1965, a seminary which was established in Tumkur merged with the BEM Theological College, a seminary, to form the present Karnataka Theological College. The present Karnataka Theological College has two traditions, the Basel Mission tradition from coastal area and the Wesleyan Methodist tradition from Bangalore and surrounding areas. By God's grace, next year we will be celebrating 175th anniversary of the establishment of this seminary. I take this opportunity to thank Reverend Elisha for inviting me to bring God's message on this special occasion of the Theological Sunday. I request you, my dear brothers and sisters, to uphold the ministry of Karnataka Theological College in your prayers. Especially when we are undergoing difficulties and trials due to the present COVID pandemic, we need your prayer support. Kindly pray for all the faculty members and the students of KTC. We also request you to support the ministry of KTC through different ways. Now, as we observe this Sunday as Theological Sunday, one of the important questions before us is that why we need theological education. There are some people, some Christians say the disciples did not have any formal theological education, but they were the best theological teachers. They were right in saying that they did not go to seminary, but they had a training under the great guru, who is none other than our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We don't have that privilege to get training under this great Lord. Right from the beginning, in the early church itself, there were theological centers, one in Antioch and one in Alexandria. And training in faith contents were given to the new converts, and ministers were trained in these theological centers. Therefore, it is very essential that we as the church give importance to the theological mission of the church. Theological education is one of the missions of the church, and we cannot ignore. One of the greatest theologians who lived in the 11th century, Saint Anselm of Canterbury, defined Christian faith as the faith which seeks understanding. Saint Anselm was the Bishop of Canterbury, and he interpreted Christian faith as faith seeking understanding, which means the faith which seeks understanding. Christian faith is the one which seeks understanding. And with understanding, we practice our faith. In order to have the correct understanding of our faith, we need theological education. While defining the church, the reformers defined it as the community, the church is the community where the word of God is preached and the sacrament is celebrated. This task is the task of the whole church. The whole church needs to preach the word of God and also celebrate the sacrament. But the whole church, all the members cannot do it. Hence, the church selects its representatives to perform the preaching and the celebration of sacrament. So on behalf of the community, this selected people perform the duties of preaching and celebrating the sacraments. And this task of the church is called as the ordained ministry. The church performs its duty of preaching and celebration of the sacraments through its ordained ministry. Hence, we need theological education. For the ordained ministry, the church trains its representatives so that they become the church instrument in the mission of preaching and celebration of the sacrament. Mission belongs to the whole church. Hence, we as the members of the church also participate in the mission of God. Mission is a partnership. Mission is a partnership between us, among us, and also partnership between us and God Himself, because it is said mission belongs to God and God invites us to participate in His mission. In today's gospel passage portrays mission as partnership. In this text, St. John's Gospel, chapter 12, verses from 20 to 26. Here we see some Greeks who were in Jerusalem wanted to meet Jesus. They were seeking Jesus. And from this text, what do we find for a theological Sunday as a message? The theme for today's meditation is knowing and doing faith. Knowing and doing faith. In order to know our faith and do our faith, we have to have three important things that we see in this passage. First one, the zeal of the Greek. The zeal of the Greeks. Greeks were the people who were seeking after truth. They were seeking new things in life. Great philosophers like Plato and Aristotle were Greeks. Even in the book of Ephesians, we see that when Paul was moving around in Athens, he saw temples for different gods. And also he came across a god who is called unknown god. This implies the Greeks' zeal to know the truth. We know how Paul preached them and made this ungod a known God. Here, we see some Greeks who came to meet Jesus. They might have heard about Jesus, his teaching, his preaching, and especially now we should know that Jesus was in Jerusalem and he had entered into Jerusalem as a king of peace, and also he had cleansed the temple. That means he has chased all the unwanted business in the temple. The business which was taking place in the Jerusalem temple was in the place which was meant for the heathens or non-Jews. These Jews might have come to Jerusalem at the time of Passover also to worship God in the temple. Now Jesus has established through his act of cleansing the temple the right of non-Jews to worship God. That is why they wanted to see Jesus and seek something from him. As Christians, we need to have the zeal of Greeks to seek after truth. We, as the disciples of Jesus Christ, do not accept the things as it is blindly. But our faith is not a blind faith. Our faith is which seeks understanding. And in that seeking, we need to have the zeal of the Greeks. Secondly, we need to have the teamwork which we see among the disciples. Christians do not practice their faith as individuals. They practice their faith as individuals in the community. Our faith has its relevance only in the context of Christian community, community of the faithful. Hence, not only our work, but also doing of our faith also implies a teamwork. The Greeks who wanted to meet Jesus, they come to Philip. Why did they come to Philip? Philip was a Greek name. And that might have made them to come to him and to seek his help. But Philip was not in a position to help them. When they asked, "We want to meet Jesus," he did not know what to do. He takes them to Andrews. And Andrews takes them to Jesus. Dear friends, many times we think that we know everything. Even if you don't know, we try to show that we know everything. And we try to do many things with our ignorance. At the end, all our efforts will lead to into nothingness, and also we sometimes put others into trouble. Here, we see honesty in Philip. He He was able to recognize that he was not able to help, but he knew where can help in that context. That's why he did not hesitate to take them to Andrews. And this is an implication for the teamwork. God has given us different talents. We are not the same. And one cannot do every work, every task. But when we pull together our talents, and when we work together as a community in a church, we can do wonders. We need to work, we need to learn to work in team. And lastly, we need to have the attitude of Jesus above all things. This is the important, most important thing. We need to have the attitude of Jesus. When they came, Jesus was telling them in verse 24, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains by itself alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit." Andrews brings these Greeks who wanted to see Jesus to Jesus. When they came to him, his reply seems to be very strange. But through this reply, Jesus was emphasizing his mission in this world. Jesus saying in verse 24 is very similar to the call which he gave to his disciples in St. Mark's Gospel chapter 10 verses 32 to 45. That means whoever wants to be the disciples of Jesus should deny themselves and become the servants of all. In verse 23, Jesus answered them and says, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified." Now in few days Jesus is going to die. And now Jesus is speaking about his glorification. "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified." What kind of glory Jesus was speaking here? The glory not of power and authority, but of service and self-denial. Jesus came as a servant. Philippians chapter 2 verses 5 to 11. Contrary to all human expectation, Jesus came as a servant of all. In St. John's Gospel chapter 13, the scene of the last night, Jesus washes the feet of his disciples. And after the act, he asks, "Have you understood what I have done? You call me Lord. Yes, indeed I am." And he gives us a call to follow the same attitude from his disciples. If you don't have the attitude of Jesus, attitude of service and self-denial, we cannot be the disciples of Jesus. My dear brothers and my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the Theological Sunday reminds us that we need to understand our faith. We need to know our faith, and also we need to do our faith. So knowing and doing our faith is the Christian life. And in order to know and do our faith, we need to have the zeal of Greeks, the teamwork of the disciples, and above all, the attitude of Jesus. Let this be your attitude, the attitude of Jesus. St. Paul gives a call. And only when we have this attitude, and when we practice that attitude in our doing of faith, we could become real Christians. May the Holy Spirit help us and guide us to know our faith and also to do our faith and to bring glory to Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
As we set aside our offerings, let us sing English hymn number 397. English hymn number 397. We shall sing the first, third, and fourth stanza. Let us dedicate our gift to God and our offerings to God and pray. O God, our Heavenly Father, from whom proceeds every good gift, sanctify this humble gift of thy church now offered to thee. Receive it as an acceptable sacrifice and use it for thy glory. We remember before thee those who have had their birthdays during the past week. Preserve them, bless them, O Lord, also in these days to come. Lead them by thy kindly light. We also remember people who have celebrated special occasions and wedding anniversaries as well. We pray that you prepare them for thy glorious kingdom. Graciously hear us, O Father, we beseech thee. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As our Lord has commanded us to pray for one another, let us make intercessions. Let us pray for theological colleges in the world. We beseech thee on behalf of our theological schools and colleges that thy good pleasure may be upon the same. Grant that who teach may be men of God, holding the mystery of faith in good consciousness, and all who learn may accept thy truth with lowly and grateful minds and walk worthily of a vocation wherewith they were called. Congregation response, hear us, O Lord. Let us pray for Christian education institutes such as Sunday school, youth, women, men, music ministry, etc. Lord, we pray for the ministry of the church as we teach the young men, women, and the elderly. We pray especially for the Sunday school, the youth fellowship, the women fellowship, the men's fellowship, and also the music ministry that the UBM churches have conducted. We pray and commit these ministries and these fellowships into your hand, as they receive the Christian education that you deserve them to have. We pray and commit the teachers and also the students who take part. We pray that you be with them and guide them as they take part in your fellowship and in your learning. Congregation responds, "Hear us, O Lord." We also pray for all the educational institutes and all the schools and secular colleges and universities. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for the educational schools and institutes in the world and in India especially, Lord. Lord, we pray and commit these schools, institutes, colleges and secular universities into your hands as they depart knowledge and education into the lives of young men and women. We pray that you guide them and be with them, and the teachers that teach them be apt and knowledgeable in their streams. Congregation responds, "Hear us, O Lord." Let us also pray for our church and the ministry of our church. We beseech thee, our Basel Mission Church and the whole United Basel Mission Church, as well as other churches of our sister congregations. Directed by the Holy Spirit, we also pray for the Presbytery Council and Synod of our churches, and also for our ministries and the works that are under the ministry. We pray that all the workers be in thy service alone. Congregation responds, "Hear us, O Lord." Amen. Let us say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Receive the benediction in faith. The grace of Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen.